टॉपिक फॉर माय पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन इज एमआरआई ऑफ द आर्टेरियोवेनस मैलफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द स्कैल्प. वैस्कुलर एनोमलीज इंक्लूड ब्रॉड स्पेक्ट्रम ऑफ लेजन्स इन्वॉल्विंग ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी एस्पेशली द हेड एंड नेक. वैस्कुलर ट्यूमर्स इंक्लूड हिमेंजियोमा, हिमेंजियोएंडोथेलियोमा, स्टफ्ड एंजियोमास एंड सारकोमास. स्लो फ्लो वैस्कुलर मैलफॉर्मेशंस इंक्लूड कैपिलरी मैलफॉर्मेशंस, वीनस मैलफॉर्मेशंस, लिम्फैटिक capillary and venous malformations, capillary lymphatic and venous malformations. High flow malformations include AVF and arteriovenous malformations, AVM. AVMs are rare congenital vascular malformations, account for only 1.5% of all vascular anomalies. However, 50% of them are noted in the oral and maxillofacial region, and it usually results from the birth defects of the vasculature. Usefulness of MRI in the diagnosis of vascular lesions on the scalp is highlighted in my presentation. On MRI, AVMs will appear as enlarged vascular channels associated with dilated feeding and draining vessels that appear as flow voids without any parenchymal staining. A discrete soft tissue mass is typically absent. However, perilesional signal abnormalities, soft tissue enhancement, and or mass-like features are some atypical findings which may be seen and that make these lesions more difficult to differentiate from the hemangiomas. AVM is an irregular direct connection between arteries and veins. Normally, arteries and veins are indirectly connected with in between the networks of very small blood vessels called as capillaries. These capillaries are important intermediaries which serve to decrease the pressure of the blood and provide a medium for nutrient or waste exchange between the blood and cells. Thus, when there is a direct communication, as in AVMs, it makes them more prone to spontaneous bleeding. They are rare congenital vascular lesions and can occur anywhere in the body. However, the most common location is in the face and maxillofacial region, constituting 50%. These can be life-threatening because of potential massive hemorrhage and thereby are the most challenging lesions to manage. Thereby, diagnostic imaging is very necessary for anatomical assessment and analysis of the nidus, the site of the arteriovenous shunting. And based on the imaging findings, integrated surgical and non-surgical interventions can be done for treatment, including sclerotherapy, endovascular or percutaneous embolization, surgical excision, or some combination of these modalities. My case report is a 14-year-old boy, which was referred to our department for the evaluation of a slowly progressive local left-sided forehead swelling since childhood and a recent onset of another smaller swelling, which was at the medial side of left eyebrow. On clinical examination, the swelling was soft, painless, and non-tender with a reddish overlying skin. And on palpation, bruise was there. There was, however, no differential warmth in the area. Patient was also giving a history of periodic eye bleed, and no other significant medical history was reported by the patient and the parents. As you can see here, this was the main swelling for which the patient was referred for evaluation for, and on the left side of the forehead, and this was the smaller swelling on the medial side of the left eyebrow. MRI findings was this ill-defined tangle of serpiginous vessels, which we can see here in the subcutaneous plane overlying the left frontotemporal scalp region, which is the major nidus, and a smaller tuft which is organizing here with the possible nidus formation can be also seen. The major feeder to this nidus is this left ophthalmic artery, which is the branch of left ICA, as we can see here. And contributing to the AVM. On this 3D VR angio image, we can see this was the bigger nidus, major nidus, which is fed by the superficial temporal artery on left side, which is a branch of external carotid artery. And we can also see the early draining veins, which are the bilateral facial veins, which are also constituting this AVM. Here we can see the intraorbital component of the AVM with the bilateral superior ophthalmic veins giving prominent flow void and contributing to the AVM. Here we can see again in this 3D MPR angio image, bilateral enlarged superior ophthalmic veins which are constituting the draining veins for the scalp AVM. Thereby concluding my presentation, AVMs are the fast flow vascular malformations. They consist of anomalous capillary beds between the arterial and venous system and thereby causing the shunting of blood. They are the most aggressive form of vascular malformation, which can lead to significant deformity and functional impairment. Fast flow vascular malformations generally become evident during childhood and puberty. However, some cases have been seen which present very late and are incidentally detected. In addition, there can also be hereditary diseases in which there is increased risk of AVM formation like HHD and VHL disease. AVM on the face or scalp is an abnormal fistula connection between the feeding arteries, early draining veins, and no intervening capillary bed, generally in the subcutaneous layer. And the draining veins are grossly dilated, they are tortuous, and they can show variceal dilatation also. The dilatation of vascular channels often results in the deformity of the scalp and face, which is usually not life-threatening, but they cause substantial cosmetic and social disturbances. Because the face and scalp have a rich arterial network, which is fed by branches of the external carotid artery, the arterial system that supplies AVM frequently is multiple and very complex. In particular, the facial lesions, which are around the midline, are being fed by bilateral arteries, whereas the forehead lesions are frequently supplied by the supraorbital branch of the ophthalmic artery, as well as by the branches of the external carotid artery. In our case also, there was feeding artery by the superficial temporal artery and also by the ophthalmic artery. MRI thereby can be used as an excellent technique in the diagnosis of these vascular malformations, either by itself or before angiography. It shows a good depiction of the vascular structure, permitting the differentiation between the high flow and the low flow lesions. High flow lesions will show typical signal flow voids, both in T2, T1 weighted images, with the appearance of the serpentine flow voids of these vessels. MRI is also able to identify the kind of flow, that is high flow or low flow, and also the origin of these vessels, that is external carotid artery mostly. And utility of the MRI also lies in the evaluation for any intracranial component of the scalp. Thanks.